possible option when I'm playing. And so my lips have to be so well trained that I can adjust them with just the flash of a thought. I just know, okay, I've got to do this, I've got to do that, and it happens instantaneously because I practice this for so many hours. It's got to get softer as you play. Again, you start at comfortable, dynamic, mezzo forte. Very slow diminuendo. Constantly evaluating your tone. Can I play any softer without losing the core of the sound? Okay, I can play a little softer. Okay, I can play. Oh, nope, that's it. A lot of it depends on also the condition of your lips affects things. I find it hard in air-conditioned hotels. It dries you out. The refrigerated air conditioning they have here is very dry, and I find that it dries my lips out faster than other places. So you have to be really conscious of what your lips are doing. So every night before I go to bed, I think, okay, lips, what are you doing? And I usually have to glom on stuff, whatever it is, so that they don't dry out during the night. So that really affects your tone as well. So it's like, really? I have to pay attention to that? And yes, the answer is yes. Okay. So it works on F, it works on F sharp, it works all the way up to B flat. But the important thing is that you really have to spend time listening to your tone at a very simple level if you want it to get better. So it's not something that, you know, you're going to spend an hour or two and wham, there you go, I've got good tone now. It doesn't happen like that. I wish it did, but it doesn't. You have to spend hours and hours listening to your sound and evaluating and trying to, what if I try this? Oh, it's airy today. Why? Okay, oh, I'm going to do that. Oh, I'm going to try this. You have to be constantly experimenting. Some of the books that work really well, also the Moise de la Sonorité is really sort of the primary source that we have for working on sound. De la sonorité, of course, means about sound. And Trevor Y has a book that's basically patterned off of that Moise book, where you find a good note, and Moise, as you know, likes the B natural above the staff. He finds a good note, and this is what you need to do yourself. Find a good note, use that as your model, and then very slowly going down and up from there, trying to match that tone quality. So lots of listening has to happen. It's not exciting. It's not flashy. But it improves every piece that you play if you get a better sound. Okay, is that okay? Any questions? I got to wrap up this portion and so we can talk about vibrato. Any questions? Yes, ma'am.
Do you work on that?
You mean up to the top?
Yeah.
Richard?